you know what? I'm gonna go for it. I have the lip's not that big a deal, so.
Okra National. Look.
So there's no better feeling knowing that when you wake up in the morning to go play golf, it's that you're gonna play well. There's no better feeling of hitting good golf shots down the fairway. Years ago, I was frustrated because I lost that. I was confused, I was frustrated, and then I met Mo Norman and learned the single plane swing. And so now I wake up every day and I know I'm gonna hit it well, I know I'm gonna play well, I know I'm gonna have fun. So my mission today is to help as many people as possible wake up every day feeling good that they're gonna go out there and play great because of the single point swing.
Okay, so this is number five. It's a good par five. There's two par fives on the front nine. It's about, from this tee box, it's about 500 and maybe 30 yards. I don't get home here very often, mostly because you have to keep it right side of the fairway. It lengthens the hole a little bit. I've hit it down there to where I get home. I just don't hit the green very often in two shots. It's a three-shot hole, generally. If you hit it hard enough down the left-hand side, you might be able to get home. But I try to keep it. You see this right here? This is the oak tree. This is Landmark's symbol for the Landmark courses. So there's an oak tree right there. So basically the line is to take it just mid of that oak tree or just on the left center of that oak tree. Now, I'm going to tee it up. If you look at this tee box, you notice that I always take the tee angle into consideration. So if I want to hit it to the left side of the fairway, I usually go towards the right side of the tee. If I want to hit it to the right side, I go left side of the tee. However, this tee box is aiming me right over the oak tree. So I can go to the middle of the tee box and I'm going to be just fine. Now, one of the things that I like to do is use, this is a triple track Callaway golf ball. I like to use the lines on the golf ball. It gives me a nice line right where I want to go over the left center of that tree. Let's knock it down there. Yeah, see, it hit, it's good. It's on the left side, actually. It hit mid fairway, kicks it left, down the left side. Might get pretty close to getting home from there. All right, so here's the fairway. It's, I think you can see how much the ball rolls down to the left by that, the way it's gone through the dew mark there. It's pretty interesting. Actually, you know, one of the things I think as you play more and more golf, you can look, my ball came in. It came in down basically the center right of the fairway. And it cruises down here. And it's almost in, look, if it goes further, that's the problem with this hole. If this fairway wasn't wet, if it was hard, it would have been all the way down there, which isn't terrible down there necessarily, but might bring that bunker into play if you hit it a little further. So you can learn a little bit out here. You learn the golf course a little bit. All right. So let me grab Leo. Now, it is so tempting to want to hit the shot at that green because, let me just measure this. I gotta get over here, just get the flag. There's a tree in the way. So it's 270. So we're gonna play 250 basically to the front of that green, 245 to 250. But here's the problem with this. And this is what everybody does on this golf course. They think, oh, it's only 250 yards. I'll hit it up there to the front of the green. The problem is it's a mess up there on the front of the green. And there's really about a 5 to 8 yard gap that you got to hit it in. I'm on the side slope. And a lot of people ask me questions, side slopes. How should I play side slopes? You know what? No one's very good at predicting how good the ball curves off a slope. Now, a 9-iron in your hand is one thing, but having a 3-wood in your hand or even a hybrid in your hand or something that's going to curve a lot, look, I'm gonna lay this back. And the reason I'm gonna lay it back is because I want a wedge in my hands to a flag. Why? If you give me a wedge in my hand, I'm gonna be inside 10 to 15 feet almost every single time. I'm gonna give myself a chance for birdie. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit something. So I got, you know, 270 to the flag. I want to have inside 100 to get in there. I need a 170-yard shot. So I'm going to hit a 7-iron or maybe even a 6-iron. Let's take a look. Actually, I'm just going to hit a 7-iron down there because I know how hard that fairway is, and it's going to take those bunkers out of play. So I'm just going to hit a little 7-iron out there to the right half, see if I can't get it in the right half. Nah, yeah, I did not hit that good. I kind of chunked it. And I don't know where it's at. This probably might not be good. I mean, ideally, you just want to hit it up here to the right-hand side and give yourself a shot. I don't even know. I don't think I've ever been down in here before. But this is one of the things. This course is so penalizing that shots like that on this golf course are the way. Oh, here it is in the bunker. So shots like that. The reason that this course is so hard is because, look, I mean, I didn't hit a good shot, obviously, but you're going to look at now what I have in front of me. So, oh, there it is right there. It's actually, there's somebody else's ball down there. So if you look at this shot. So I'll measure this, but look, bunker shots are hard. Look at the lip sitting in front of me. I'm in the bunker. Dude, this is why it's hard. This is Oak Tree National right here. This is it's rearing its ugly head because you want to say, well, can I get a shot high enough to get over this lip and get it onto that green? And you know what you're better off doing? Here's what I'm going to do. You're going to think I'm crazy. I've played here enough. I'm going to just going to chunk it out to the front and just try to get it up and down. That's all you can really do here. And now this is a par five, and you should be able to make birdie here, but not today. I'm gonna get in here and measure how far I got though, just because I wanna see what my yardage is to the flag. 90 yards. To the flag. Let's take a look. Let's get down in here and take a look. You know what? I'm gonna go for it. The lip's not that big a deal, so I'm gonna go ahead and just see if I can't hit a 90-yard shot onto that green. Which I chunked it, but pretty typical. But that's pretty normal though, because now I'm just sitting down there in front of the green, get it up and down for a par. So it's not that big a deal. And that's kind of why I went for it. I kind of aimed a little right. I said, well, you know, if you don't hit it good, you'll just be on the right hand side. So it's actually fine. Let's go get that up and down. Let's check it. All right, so just in front of the green here. I'm actually gonna walk this. One of the things that I like to do when I am close enough to the green with my wedges, I like to walk the yardage just a little bit. So let me just walk this off. I'm gonna actually pace this off, see how far I got. All right, so check this out. So I got 23 paces to about right here. But then I have this downslope, and the worst place I can land this ball is on that downslope because it gives the ball energy. So what I try to do when I'm hitting shots like this is I try to land it on top of the flat spot. This is my area that I kind of want to land this shot. So I'm going to measure from this area right here. Yeah, so about 23 paces. So just a little short of 23 paces, I think, will be a great little shot. And let's see if I can't knock this in there. Here we go. Yeah, it's really good. So Notice I did. I landed that kind of on that spot. It kicked a little bit left, but then it rolled up there, so about 2 feet maybe. All right, so that was a pretty good shot. I liked it. I landed it. I actually landed it slightly short of where I had planned, so I landed it right there. Kicked a little left, but you can look at it. It's a couple feet, maybe 3 feet. It's in pretty good shape. All right, just breaks a little bit from the right edge there. All right, so that's good. And that's the thing about, so look what just happened there, right? Hit a decent drive. Didn't hit a good approach. Hit it back, bad in the bunker in the left. Then I had to figure out, how can I manage this hole from there? And my wedge saved me. So that wedge game, I'll tell you what, if you can have a wedge game that saves your game, that's how you play. Okay, round number six. This hole, it's not a long hole at all. This is a 400, under 400 yard, maybe 412 par four. The thing about this hole from this tee box, is that my brother and I had this conversation about this hole. This is the hole I think is the hardest hole on the course because of the approach shot into the green. And so the tee shot's semi-difficult. You gotta keep it on the right half if you can. It'll play a little longer today since it's a little wet out here this morning. So it's gonna play a little bit longer, but it's really, after you get your tee shot in play, it's really mostly about that approach. You're gonna check this shot out. There we go. So that's probably the best shot I've hit here in a couple months. So watch when I get up there though, because it's really not, that tee shot's okay. I'm gonna have 150 to 60 into the green, but it's how this green is set up, and I'll show you. This is a very difficult shot. Let's check it out. All right. Let's measure this one really fast. Like I said, pretty decent drive. Maybe not as, let's see what I got left. All right, so it says 127 to the flag, 131 with slope, pins in the middle of the green. The reason this shot's so hard is, number one, the green is semi-elevated. There is a false front on this green that if you don't hit it far enough, it comes down and you'll have a shot that's a real difficult uphill, barely see the flag shot. So, and then I'm on a uphill side hill lie. So you're getting some movement of the golf ball coming into the green. So I got to hit this 131 yards. So this is going to be, you know, it's funny, in the first hole I hit a 9-iron from 165. I'm going to hit a 9-iron here, but I'm not going to hit it a full steaming 9-iron. My wedge goes about 127 yards, and if I hit a 127 yard shot from this upslope, it may not get all the way there, and I'm dealing with a false front. So I'm going to take out one more. I'm going to take a little bit off of it, so choke down just a little bit. That's how I kind of slow the club down. I choke down a little bit, take a little bit off of it, and hit a nice smooth 9-iron in there, see if I can't get it back to that flag. All right, let's do this. Can't see it into the sun, but we'll see. It's not bad. I caught a little thin. Take a look. So I hit it a little thin from the fairway, but I got away with it. I hit it good enough. Here is, let's walk this off to see how far this is. This is 20 feet, 22 feet. I gotta tell you, I'd be happy with a shot every single day. This the way this green sets up, I'm gonna leave the flag in so you guys can see it. So the way this green sets up, it's so narrow. Like this green is so narrow in here that you have to get your club selection right. Otherwise, I've been back behind the green so often here. If you hit it short, it's down the slope, down there, you know, 20 feet below the green. So club selection here is difficult, and that's why this hole is really a good hole. And that back hole location over there, look at that. Green's tiny, you gotta hit it over top of the slope. You know, even though you may only have a 9-iron or a wedge in your hand, it's a very, very difficult hole. Okay, let's read this putt. All right, I got it coming off the slope a little bit. I think it's going, I got some shade here. I'm gonna take my glasses off because I can't see it. I gotta go on left at first and then right up by the hole. So I'm gonna play it just on the right edge, I think. Told you. Goes left here, slid off right by the hole. Okay, number 7, par 4, good hole here. Probably 440 yards. By the way, the yardage guy that I use a lot of times doesn't have the right yardage just because it's from the 88 PGA Championship. So all the yardages from the fairway are good, but they've lengthened this course quite a bit over the years. So, all right, I'm gonna play this. So once again, I wanna be in the left half. I'm gonna go to the right side of the tee. And I'm gonna try to hit it just down. I'm gonna just hit it left center of fairway. Hole goes slightly left. Man, that's gonna be good. That one was really good. That one, what happened was I hit a little bit of draw on it, which didn't mind it, and it curved right around this bunker, which is out there. This is as far down as I can get the ball down there. That was a good shot. Yeah, this hole is, so the right side is protected with a big bunker, and I've been in there many times. And you think, oh, if I hit it on the right side, it's all going to kick to the left, which it does. Then it catches the bunker on the right. So that's a really bad place to be because I've never really been able to hit a good shot out of that bunker because it's protected by a big lip. So you kind of favor left side. It's kind of where you want to be on this hole is left side favored. So this one I kind of hit a tiny little draw on the end of it, but I like that kind of curvature to it sometimes because it creeps it down here. And we'll see where this thing is here. So I saw it rolling up here around. And look, it just came right over the edge of this bunker. So this is pretty far down here. This ball from that tee, I'll tell you how far I have left in the green. This hole being in the, you know, 440 from that tee. Let's see how far I got left. So 116 to the flag. So, you know, that ball went over 300 yards, but it's a lot of that's just using the slope of the golf course. You know, I probably only hit that about 280, and it came running down here. So 116, okay. So here's what I got to show you this real quick, because I have this is my pitching wedge. This club here goes 125 yards. Obviously, 125 is too much for this shot, but I'm gonna do one more measurement. Every time I get a wedge in my hand, I like to double measure just because I want to hit, yeah, okay, 116. So just think about it. So how do I hit a wedge shot? I still want to make a nice aggressive swing, but what I'm going to do on this is I'm going to just choke down a little bit. When I choke down on this wedge all the way to here, I hit 102. So I'm just gonna be right in the middle of the wedge. This is gonna go right at about 110 yards. And I think this will take enough speed off this club. I think it'll be perfect. Sit right there, sit right there, sit right there, sit right there. Oh, it's strong. A little long. I knew I caught that one really good. But one of the reasons that that ball went a little bit long was just because the pin is tucked on the back. And the good thing, the interesting thing about this course is, look, I had to carry this bunker. So I got to carry this bunker and tuck it in behind that flag. I got a wedge in my hand, which makes me want to go after it. So you're going to see, it's an all carry shot. The pin is on a tiny little corner. And you got really, look where you got to land the ball. You got about 5 yards in there to land the ball. So for me, I hit a really good shot. It just went a little bit long, and you end up, you'll see where I'm at. It's not terrible. So look at the shot I had here. I had to carry the bunker, land it in that little area here, and then I got a little room back here. So, you know, I had a wedge in my hand, and I'm gonna go after that flag with a wedge usually. But then again, I hit it a little far, and you can see where it ended up here. It ends up back here, kind of in a little tricky situation where I now have to land it on this downslope. So, you know, you take it out of a hole location that's kind of tucked away, which this one is, and you can put yourself in these situations. It's not terrible, better off than being short. But if this hole would have been located towards the middle of the green and it left the whole front of the green, I would have probably hit a different club because I would have taken a front measurement as opposed to have to fly it all the way to 116. So that was kind of my decision there. I don't know if it's a good or a bad one, but let's hit this shot. So I got to bump this up there and just get it down the slope. So I'm going to kind of be basically dead hand this just a little bit. Just try to get some energy on the ball to get it down on the slope and let it run down a little bit. Not bad, you know, foot and a half, 2 feet there. And let me just tap this in. All right, so we got out of there. You know, when you get a wedge in your hand, you want to try to make birdies, but this course, I'll tell you, sometimes, I mean, I hit a really good drive, got it down there within a wedge of the green, but then didn't hit a good wedge shot, or hit a good shot, just didn't hit the right yardage, and sure enough, got away with par, but that's the way it works. It's golf. Let's grab the rangefinder here, and let's look down here and see how far we got. Okay, 156. So, but here's the thing. This is a par 3, 156 yards. That flag, is on the front of the green. And it's tucked. It's tucked over the bunker, so it's a 150 carry, basically, over that little ridge there. Now, look what I'm going to do here. And if you can see where this hole, how it sets itself up, it's not a very long par 3, but I'm going to aim kind of right quarter of the green and just let it come back. It's kind of straight downwind just a little bit. It's only the wind has really calmed down, so it's not very much. But I'm going to go to this left side of the tee. I like the left side of the tee here because if you think about it, it lets the right side of the green have a little more favor. All right, so I'm gonna hit the 8-iron. And you know, this is between 9 and 8, but the 8 gets me over that bunker and it doesn't put that bunker into play as much. So let's go ahead and hit the 8. So I hit it pretty good. It flew about 152, so it just barely got over the bunker, but it's not bad. Should have a relatively short 15 footer there for birdie. All right, so got it on the front of the green here, so not bad. Like I said, you know, that's between an 8 and 9 iron, and I hit the 8, not terrible, but you know, it got me over the bunker and into a spot where I can make a putt. But the, you know, the thing about playing golf is it's about managing your feelings to me. You know, how do you feel on the shot before you hit it? Like on that shot, for example, did I feel like, you know, I knew the yardage, right? I took the yardage as 156, but I sat there and I was like, okay, how do I feel on the shot? And, you know, one of the things about getting technical on the course to me is a mistake. Like I'm not getting swing technical when I'm out here. I'm feeling around the course. Matter of fact, as I play further and further into a round and I start feeling better, I might make harder swings or more aggressive swings or take more aggressive shots at flags. So how I gauge how I feel the entire time I'm playing. How do I feel about particular shots? How do I feel about that particular shot? If I sit over a ball and it doesn't feel right, I usually just back off. Just back off and say, okay, it doesn't feel right. So you gotta pay attention to that when you're playing. So let's just make a putt here. All right, let's get a quick read. So one of the things you can do on putting is if you're like this one looks pretty straight, but I'm gonna go here to the right. And the reason I'm walking to the right just a little bit is I wanna see where the thing starts breaking off to the left. So that's a little bit there. Then I'm gonna go over here. So this is actually more straight. So this thing might break a little left, actually. So I always try to maybe get a little feel for which way. So I'm gonna go right edge here, right side. Yeah, it was a good putt. It was a good putt. I don't know about this whole flag in the hole thing. Psychologically for me, I played my entire life with the flag out of the hole. And now when I see the flag sitting in the hole, and this is maybe just me, maybe it's just I'm a little bit psychotic when it comes to this, but it looks like the hole's smaller because it's filled it up. And not that that should make that big a difference. My brother likes the flag in, I don't like it in. And I struggle with that flag being in the hole. I want it out because I want to see the entire cup. And if for some reason I see the ball, you know, you visualize a putt going into the hole. Well, I see this flag sitting there. So it kind of drives me crazy. I lip out the ball a lot when the flag's in the hole. But it was a good putt. I hit a good line. I read it good. All I care about when I'm putting, if I hit my line and I hit a good putt, I don't even care if it goes in. Now, I misread them sometimes, but as long as so that's just a reading problem, right? That's not a putting problem. So I don't care if I miss putts. I care if I hit my line and hit good putts. I hit a really good putt there, so I'm happy with that. Okay, number 9. This, you know that debate on what's the hardest hole? 1, is it 2, is it 3, is it 4, is it 5? This, debatably, could be one of the hardest holes on the course. I'm gonna play it from 427, but I want you to look here. This right here, we're about 435. There's a tee box back there at about 450, and there's one back there at 480, 475, 480. So this hole here, when they play the major events, they never play it from back there. They always play it from up here. And you have to carry, from this tee, you'll have to carry a 230-yard to 240-yard carry just to get to the fairway. And then obviously you get down there and then we'll see how good I hit it, what club I have into the green. When this holds into the wind and you're playing it from back here at the 440, when this holds into the wind, you have to hit your best shot to get it to the fairway. So I think look, here's the way I look at this hole. And this is the way I always tell the people that play this hole with me. It's a par 4 where you can make birdie, or it's just a par 5. Because the minute you hit this tee shot, you'll know if it's a par 4 or par 5. So anyway, so let's get up here and let's try to hit a good shot. Now, once again, let's just, since this is the last hole for today, let's just take a look at tee angle one last time. This designer, Pete Dye, said, look, let's line everybody up at the right trees. So this tee box kind of lines you up at the right trees. So it's already favoring, kind of pushing you away from the fairway. So I'm actually going to go a little bit to the right half of the tee. Of course, this brings that bunker on the left a little more into play. However, that's the beauty of the hole, because now you got a little more left side into play. So I got, okay, left corner, the shot here is bunker on the left, over the right side of that at some point there. So I'm lined up right there. That really is the best line. I feel the wind coming a little bit from my left here. So I'm kind of feeling the wind a little bit from my left. And I'm going to swing a little bit more aggressively at this one. And that is in the right trees. Exactly where he lined me up. Okay, so let's go hit the shot, because I hit this one yesterday. You'll have fun with this one. Before we go look at the ball over there, come over here for a second. So obviously this is my target area right here in the fairway. But even if I hit the fairway, I don't know if you can see the clock? That's the flag behind that massive bunker. It's 170 yards from right here. Probably 185 to that flag tucked in the back. This hole is incredible, really, if you think about it. It's such a great hole. I mean, the guys in the Senior Open in 2014, they had a playoff and they came to this hole hitting 5 irons into this green. Now, I hit it in the trees off the tee, and this one thing you learn quickly is how not to be stupid when you play golf. Because I could sit there and go, okay, watch this. I'm going to cut it around the tree. And everybody talks to me all the time about, well, you got to shape the ball. Hang on a second. Let's look at this. Just come look at this for a second. First of all, I'm semi lucky to be able to get a club on it. The lie is what it is. It's not fantastic. I can get it over that tree, but what is it good does it do me? Because I can't, the flag is, look at the clock. See, I got trees, right? This is dead. This is just dead. So here's what you got to do on this. This is called stop trying to perform miracles. That flag is way behind the bunker. What I got to do is I want to get it down the fairway towards the far left side of the green to have a shot back up at that flag. So I'm going to grab a 5 iron, which when I punch it out of this grass, it's probably going to go maybe goes. Yeah, I got a decent fly. So this will go 150 or 60 yards if I hit it decent. And I'll try to scoot it down to the far left side of that fairway. I'm going to just choke down, punch it down through the front left of that green. Get up there. Oh, sit. That's magical right there. Hitting the green from that spot, oh my God, that's awesome. I got that shot now. Now I know how to hit that shot, thanks to this YouTube channel. So, that was amazing right there. I hit it in the trees. I have no shot at all. I'm blocked out. And then I take a shot and I punch it out and look, I just kind of punched it down to get it, and it rolled it down the fairway all the way up the slope. It could have easily gone down there, but you know, it had the right weight to it. And I don't know. I mean, that's what golf is. You know, you're playing what you can, what's in front of you. So that was great there. Now this, doesn't mean it left me with an easy putt, because look, that pin's tucked way to the right. That's why I really had no shot at the flag. It came up the slope, and now I got this massive mound in front of me. This is what I'm gonna walk this off. I'll tell you how far this is. Let me walk this. So I got about 80 feet. I got an 80 footer, and I hit a pretty good shot there. So look, there's no gimmies out here at Oak Tree National. That's what makes this course so freaking fun, because if you play good and hit good shots, you can shoot good scores. If you're in scramble mode like I am on this hole, we have a saying here, this course never gives up. It never gives up on you. You're never gonna have a day where it just gives up too many birdies. So all right, so I got 80 feet. This thing's gonna slope off to the right quite a bit. It just goes straight to the right. All right, let's hit it up on the slope and see if I can't get it down there. Get down there. That's not great. Left myself a little 5-footer. All right, I'm pulling the flag on this. I am pulling the flag. I do not like flagging the hole. All right, this is going definitely this direction. Yep, all right. Just outside left, just a little bit. Not bad. Not bad to get away with there with 4 from that situation in the trees. But isn't that what golf is, though? Isn't golf a game where, that's why we like it so much, because you can take, look, do I want to hit it perfect? Yes, I want to hit every shot perfect. That drive, hit it to the right. But then you got to make the best out of it, right? You got to figure out a way to create something. And I can tell you, like that shot out of the trees, I'm punching a shot out of there. I didn't know it was going to stop right here on the green. I thought it could be there. But by hitting it on this line, it gave me an opportunity to hit it in this area and then have some kind of short game to get it up and down, or, you know, get 2-putt for par. So that's why I love the game. If I walked off the course right now and said, okay, what do I want to work on, right? So one of the things that I will do right now, since I just wrapped up the front nine and I'm going to play the back later, I would actually assess what things do I want to work on. I don't feel like I hit my driver that well today. So, and by the way, I hit tons of drivers. I love to get great with a driver. So I'm going to spend a practice session. I'm going to have a practice session on the range with a driver. What else? Hit a couple wedge shots I didn't like. So I'm going to go gauge some more wedges in. Those are the two ends of the bag. And obviously I'm always going to work in my putting. Well, look, that's how you do it. You play a round of golf, you figure out what your strengths and weaknesses are, you find out where you needed some work, and you go spend some time working on it, and you get that much better every time you practice. That's what I'm gonna do this afternoon, so I'm gonna go do a practice session. So I just wrapped up the front nine here at Oak Tree National. It was a blast. I shot even par. Is that great? Look, it's not terrible, right? I didn't have too many birdie opportunities, but you know what? That's this course. How many times did I have actually a wedge or a short iron in my hand coming into a green? I think it was one time. So that's the beautiful thing about this course. It's hard. I was lucky to get away with par there on the last hole. But anyway, that was a blast. Hope you guys enjoyed this. If you're enjoying the course blogs and me spending time on the course, talking through shots and showing you shots, give me a thumbs up and tell me you liked it. And also subscribe to the channel, because I'm gonna do more on golf courses like Oak Tree National. I'm even gonna play the back nine.